I'm TJ Manotok and this is your TFC News Now.
We begin with millions of members of the LGBTQ community and their allies taking part in this year's Pride celebrations in several major cities like New York, San Francisco, Seattle, and Chicago over the weekend. But amid the festivities, they say the fight continues for equality, as there have been increasing efforts from Republican leaders to restrict LGBTQ rights. The American Civil Liberties Union has tracked close to 500 anti-LGBTQ bills in the 2023 state legislatures, a record high for the last century. There's also been a GOP-led push to limit drag in at least 15 states in the last few months. And in Florida, this year, education officials extended Governor Ron DeSantis' 2022 initiative limiting LGBTQ discussions in schools through the third grade, also known as the Don't Say Gay Bill, to now cover all public school grades. Gina Palpalato, who goes to Pride celebrations in San Francisco every year, says the community needs to stay focused on speaking up and taking action.
It is very important to be here, especially now, because we are celebrating the LGBT rights, and especially the marginalized LGBT people in Florida and other states. So we have to raise awareness and show that we are people of love and love wins.
In sports, Filipino fighter Jade Bornea fell short in his quest for a world title, suffering a bloody TKO loss to Argentina's Fernando Martinez. Still, the 28-year-old Bornea showed some grit against the IBF Super Flyweight champion in an action-packed fight. In the ninth round, Martinez hit Bornea with a solid left, causing blood to pour out of his ear. While Bornea tried to continue fighting, referee Charlie Fitch called the bout 29 seconds into the 11th round. After the fight, Bornea explained that he felt the first 8 rounds were fairly even, but the ear injury had changed the momentum of the fight. After this second straight successful title defense, Martinez says he now hopes to land a title unification match. In the undercard action, former IBF Superfly champion Jerwin Ancaja scored a 5th-round TKO over Colombian Wilner Soto. Ancaja, who is fighting 2 weight divisions above his previous campaign, landed multiple body shots throughout the early rounds before a combination dropped Soto in the 4th round. 3 straight right hooks to the body forced Soto to his knee, bringing the fight to an end in the 5th round.
Jungle did this because this can't be all you.
Y'all don't like it?
And finally, in entertainment news, we get to know FilAm actor Martin Martinez. Martinez grew up in Northern California, where he started his performing career in theater. He starred with Wednesday star Jenna Ortega in the 2018 movie Saving Flora, and has appeared in several other projects. He is currently in Primo, the coming-of-age comedy series that's praised by critics as one of the best new shows of the year. Martinez says that as a Filipino-Latino American, he felt at home with the show's emphasis on family.
My mom is a first-generation immigrant from the Philippines, and she made it like very, it was important for us to always visit our Lola and Lolo at our aunt and uncle's house, and so my siblings and I would spend a lot of time there, and that's where I was really immersed in the culture and the food, and everything always revolved around a lot of food.
The 22-year-old actor is also part of the hit series Magnum P.I.
And those are your headlines for today. Catch more of our stories online at news.abs-cbn.com/tfcnews and on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel. I'm TJ Manotok. Stay with us, Kapamilya.